zombie apocalypse. Give a bit of mmm to me, and I give a bit of mmm to you. Give a bit of mmm to me, and I give a bit of mmm to you. Give a bit of mmm to me, and I give a bit of mmm to you.
sure is quiet. That's not the worst that... Yes?
Hephaestus whining.
Athena and Aphrodite bicker.
Ah, there's that wonderful smell again.
Ambrosia is life. You want increased protection? Distill it here and drink up. Then enjoy the ride. One time, Athena downed that whole Kilix and destroyed the entire Greek fleet right after she had sided with them in battle. It was epic. Sorry, guess you just had to be there.
Many of my relatives were. They died.
And I told Athena not to do that. But did she listen? No. Try not to impale yourself on anything.
But Phoenix wasn't listening. She was drawn to the forge by a hidden force. The Aramantine she'd gathered, calling out to be reshaped. Phoenix let the empty compliment die in the ensuing silence, and instead tried to focus on potential potion recipes.
Those are a few ideas for ways to stick it to Typhon. You mortals seem to need an incentive, so I'll pay you Electrum for accomplishing each. And since I'm the god of merchandise, you can spend it right here on, you guessed it, merchandise.
Ooh, creative.
Or you could always just pay me your own Electrum.
I thought the incentive was for me.
I'm the god of financial gain.
Those prices! Wow!
I'm also the god of thieves. We all have our vices.
What's that underneath?
It's a chore chart. Someone has to get Ares to clean up after himself. Ever tried to get blood out of a sea of blood? Now that is a feat.
I'm here selling, if you're buying.
Oh, is this where the gods get their dental exams?
No, it's where we rip off our skin to change our appearance.
Huh. Still better than visiting the dentist.
Sure. Hades had it delivered. Deposit an offering for the ferryman, and unexpected help could very well arrive. Be careful, though.
Argo broke the last gift from the underworld, and look what happened to him.
Who's Argo?
Exactly.
Phoenix stumbled upon a winged creature. As Phoenix freed the small creature imprisoned on the isle, she let out a cry, which meant, "Great hero, I am but a piece of Nike, the goddess of victory. Please free the others, so I may return to my full glory."
They won't win without Nike. She's like a glove or a thing you wear that protects you while running. A helmet. So, what is it?
Phoenix would need to free it to find out.
Yeah, but you can tell me now.
Can you please respect my narrative pace? The Valley of Eternal Spring. Its highlights include a massive tree that reaches up to the heavens. The Hall of the Gods. Eros's Palace.
Oh, I'm glad he finally got his happy ending.
And a palace belonging to the Goddess of Beauty herself.
Of course Aphrodite would claim the prime real estate with the best view. As long as she's safe from prying eyes, I'm happy.
From such great heights, a fluttering of birds, feeding from the most beautiful apple tree, caught Phoenix's eye.
Phoenix was about as high as I was when I thought marrying Aphrodite off to Hephaestus would stop the other gods from fighting over her.
Yes, that view from Mount Olympus is something else. I haven't seen it in years.
You're not getting that high again, so stop asking!
Ugh! come back whenever you're hungry. You hear? And be sure to tell all your fellow creatures that I am here to serve them. Fresh apples available night and day. If I could move, I'd deliver. Say.
Happen to be Aphrodite?
Why, yes, I am. Pleasure to humbly make your acquaintance.
Phoenix, sorry, I'm just such a fan. You're responsible for some of the most epic love stories of all time. I have to admit, I wasn't expecting a tree, but even in your, arboreal state, you're beautiful.
That's sweet of you to say, but the only mirror I gaze into these days reflects the happy smiles of the creatures I help. If only I could travel to those most in need. But alas, my roots keep me anchored here.
So that's why Typhon did this to you. So you can't use your beauty to move ships or inspire bravery in battle against him.
Me? Start a war? I don't know where you get such outlandish ideas. True beauty is found in acts of service. True love is the giving of yourself to others. The name Aphrodite should have stood for those things all along.
She did not just say that.
I am reformed now. My old essence locked away in a vault, wedged under my largest root, which is for the best.
Maybe I could get that essence back for you. I'm going to need allies to go up against Typhon.
We have the hungry to think about.
You said you need to free yourself from your roots. To feed the hungry, of course. Well, my roots were as a pretty bad farmer. So I know how to hurt plants. Salt. It shrivels them up.
Oh, would that work? But of course, my roots are not ordinary. They're primal. Powerful.
So we'll need, mythical salt water? Oh! Oh! This is in the prophecy! A pearl in rough seas! You were a pearl born from rough seas! The salty sea foam from your birth!
Yes! What an inspired proposal! But I couldn't possibly trouble a stranger to recreate the conditions of my birth.
What if a stranger asked to be troubled?
If a stranger asked to be troubled, then I suppose I wouldn't really be troubling them at all. Here's how to conjure sea foam from my birthplace.
I already know all about this. Mom loved this story. Grandpappy Uranus threw a pearl into the sea. The sea churned into foam, and Aphrodite rose up out of it.
A pearl, Grandpappy? I'm not sure that's how it...
That's definitely the story.
Okay. I'm sure that's how it went, down.
Got it. Knock a pearl into the ocean really hard. That sounds simple enough.
Oh, thank you, Phoenix. I'll be serving fresh apples to the less fortunate across the Golden Isle in no time.
Well, this is weirder than the time Demeter turned that kid into a lizard.
Here comes the...